हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द अनदर वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ एडीएस सब्जेक्ट। प्रीवियसली वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट असिम्प्टोटिक नोटेशंस। इन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड टू असिम्प्टोटिक नोटेशंस विच आर आवर बिग ओ नोटेशन एंड आवर ओमेगा नोटेशन। बिग ओ नोटेशन इज यूज फॉर worst case time complexity of algorithm, means that suggest upper bound of your algorithm. Next was omega notation. Omega notation is used for best case, it suggests lower bound for your algorithm. Now in our this lecture we will study about third operation or third notation, which is theta notation. So let's start with it. So theta notation represents average case of algorithm's time complexity. It denotes asymptotically tight bound, or we can say both lower bound and upper bound. For definition, a function fn is equal to theta of g of n if there exist c1 and c2 positive constant and n and 0 positive integers, such that c1 into g of n less than or equal to fn less than or equal to c2 into g of n for all n is greater than or equal to n0 and n0 greater than or equal to 1 and last c is greater than or equal to 0 c is greater than c0. So here our change is that in previous omega and big O there was only a single condition, that was between function and c into gn. But here for the theta we have two conditions here. First condition is c1 into g of n less than or equal to fn, and another condition is fn less than or equal to c2 into g of n. So here understand, in that we are using this condition c1 into g of n less than or equal to fn for checking our best case. Check this statement, it was into our omega notation. Another is fn is less than or equal to c2 into g of n. Observe this operation, this is same which is used into big O notation. So our average case suggests that this both condition can be true for tight bound. So we have to check all the conditions which are true for this both conditions. So for that we will take a example. Our example is 3n plus 2. So 3n plus 2 is our function. For that we have to keep in mind this statement. For that, if we take our c1 is equal to 1 and c2 is equal to 4, so we will have this statement: 1 into n less than or equal to 3n plus 2 and less than or equal to 4 into n. So here, as the equation suggests, 1 is our c1, n is our g of n, 3n plus 2 is our fn, 4 is our c2, and n is our g of n. So for this we have to check that for n's value these are true or not. So for checking, let's put n is equal to 1. So after putting n is equal to 1, our equation will be 1 into 1 less than or equal to 3 plus 2 less than or equal to 4 into 1. So here we can see that this condition is true here. Means 1 is less than or equal to 5. But this condition is false here because 5 is not less than or equal to 4. So we cannot take n is our g of n. So we have to check for another example. So here we have put n is equal to 2. So if we put n is equal to 2, our equation will be 2 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 8. So our for n is equal to 2, this condition is true. If we check it for n is equal to 3, then also this will be true. So we can say for all n is less than or equal to 2, this condition will be true. So fn is equal to theta of n, from where we can see that from here we can check that our function 3n plus 2, which is upper bound, lower bound and average bound, for all we can say that here n is our tight bound. Why? Because it is in upper bound also and it is in lower bound also. So theta notation represents a single number. We cannot say that n cube is of tight bound. It will be okay for only the big O notation. We can not say that log n is for tight bound, because it will be okay for the lower bound, means omega notation, but that will be not okay for the both lower and upper bound. So we have to take n as a value that is a tightly bound, and n will be our average bound for this example. So this is the theta notation. Okay, so again let's remember that big O, which represent worst case, and it will be okay for the upper bounds. Second was the omega notation. It will represent best case and it will be true for all its lower bounds. And last one is our theta notation. So it will be our average case and it will be okay for only and only its tight bound. So these are the asymptotic notations. Thank you, students.